animal ornaments, like the dewlap size in certain types of lizards, tail length in some birds. Deer antlers or peacock feathers are very differently distributed in nature than you might expect. What we did was we took an existing qualitative theory for why animal ornaments exist, and we tried to make it quantitative. We created a mathematical model, and we found that this mathematical model actually made predictions that were beyond those of the qualitative theory. They split into two groups, one group that's really flashy, the really showy, flashy ornaments, and another group that's subdued and that save their resources, that don't spend so much on investment in ornament, but can survive a little bit better. Growing these ornaments takes resources. Deer regrow their antlers every year, for example, and they can cost them their lives. They can even get stuck in trees when their antlers are too big. So the question is, why do they bother investing in these ornaments? And there was a qualitative theory that existed. This is a hobby handicap principle, which says that animals grow flashy ornaments for the purpose of advertising their fitness. But it also says that these ornaments have to be costly. They can't be something that's easy to grow, because if they were easy to grow, even the unfit individuals would grow them and you wouldn't get any signaling of fitness. There's a really appealing analogy to make to humans, and I don't want to push it too far, but the natural analogy that everyone wants to make is that individuals can also try to appear more fit by spending resources on things that cost a lot of money, like expensive cars, expensive suits, flashy clothing, houses. It's conspicuous consumption is the idea that the only way you can afford to spend so much money on some particular necklace or car is that is if you already have a lot of money. So it's demonstrating wealth by throwing away a lot of wealth. In that sense, it's analogous to this process that Zahavi's handicap principle describes, which is that animal ornaments demonstrate fitness by hurting fitness. I would not conflate this or connect it to the idea of human fitness, physical fitness, or of human evolution. We don't know that there's really any connection there, but it's a nice analogy.